Hi everyone. In this video, we're going to be going through how we add switch addresses to our turnouts and also the sensors as well. So what this will do is when we click on the turnout here on our main line track, which is a right-hand turnout running into our passing siding, this will activate via the Digitrax SE8Cs the tortoise slow motion switch machines that I have hooked up to the layout. So what we'll do now is we'll go in and we'll add those switch addresses for the turnouts and also the sensors as well. So to begin, we do a right click on the turnout itself, go down to edit, which opens up our edit turnout window. Expand that a little bit more. Then what we need to do is click on turnout and we can manually enter or scroll down the turnout that we want to place. Then what we need to do is add our sensor as well, so we can do this in the one window, so we can add the turnout switch address for the turnout and also the sensor for that particular block as well. So we click create edit, which brings up our edit block screen. Again, clicking back on sensor, clicking down the drop down box and making sure that LS3 is selected, click apply, click OK, and then click done. And then what will happen now is you'll see that in this turnout here, it's just disappeared. That's because the state of the turnout's unknown. So if we click on it again, you'll notice that the solid line that was running through here is now changed back to the way it was. And if we click on the turnout itself, it actually routes from the main line through to the passing siding. So now we know that we have this turnout hooked up to the switch address, which is LT89. And whenever that is clicked by the dispatcher on Panel Pro, or via the push button switch on our fascia panels on the layout, that this turnout will now activate. So what we need to do now is just add the sensor icon above that. So again, we go up to the top of the screen, the sensor icon, click there, select LS3 from the drop-down box, holding the shift key, do a left click over the top of the turnout, and then we can add that sensor. So at this time, it's in an unknown state. You can see by the text label that comes up, it's LS3. And if we click that, that turnout is now occupied. And if we click it across like that, you can see that it's on a diverging route through to the passing siding, but still occupied, and we can manually turn that off. And that's it for this video.